Best Google Camera 6.2 settings for the Xiaomi Poco F1. If you haven't already subscribed, make sure you subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to get notified of new videos. Hey peeps, what's up? Manchi here, back with another video, and today we're going to have a look at the best Gcam settings for the Xiaomi Poco F1. The Google camera I'm using in this video is from Sanity, and these settings are also recommended by him. After testing these settings for a few days, I think, in my opinion, they are the best settings for this Gcam 6.2 port for the Xiaomi Poco F1 by Sanity. The APK being used in this video is also linked in the description of this video. Do note, you might have a different opinion and you might not like the settings, but you know, photography is a personal preference, and what are the best settings for me and Sanity might not be the best settings for you. So if you find something which is better, works better than this, is best for you, make sure to leave a comment down below with your settings. Without any further delay, let's go ahead and check out the settings. We'll open the Google camera application, click on more, and then click on settings. The first few settings are purely a personal preference, whether you want to toggle the save location switch or not, whether you want camera sounds or not, whether you want Google Lens suggestions or not, what are the gestures you want to use, whether you want to see a grid on your viewfinder or not. So we'll skip these and leave these for you to decide how you want to set them up. Let's start with the photo settings. The back camera photo resolution needs to be set as 12.2 with a ratio of 4:3. The back camera lens blur resolution needs to be set the same, which is 4:3, 12.2 megapixel. The back camera model needs to be set as Pixel 3 XL. The front camera photo resolution needs to be set as 4:3, 5 megapixels. Now, before you come back to me and ask me how you can take 20 megapixel selfie shots using the Poco F1 because the camera on the front is 20 megapixel, you cannot do that using the Google camera mod, because 5 megapixels is a limitation of this APK from Google itself. Nothing Sanity can do about that. As for the front camera model, you can leave it as Nexus 6P. Now, if you ask me why are we not using Google Pixel 3 XL or 3A XL, I did try changing them to Google Pixel 3 and 3A XL, and the difference in quality of photograph when compared to the Nexus 6P is not much. It's almost the same. So I'd rather go with the settings which the developer himself recommends. As for the video settings, you have HD 1080p. You can of course change it to 4K or 720p, whatever you prefer. Front camera resolution again 1080p. Then the bitrate, you need to set this as 60 Mbps. 4K time lapse is again an optional toggle. If you want to record your time-lapse videos in 4K, you do have that option over here, and you can either enable it or disable it based on your personal preference. Video stabilization needs to be set as on. Yes, Google camera ports now have video stabilization. At the time of recording this video, it only works in 1080p 30fps and 4K 30fps. I have a separate video showing those off, which are linked in the description of this video, and it will also pop up as a card on the top right of your screen. Next up, let's scroll up a little and then click on advanced. Here we have show dirty lens warning. Of course, I personally recommend that you keep this guy as enabled, because if you have something on your camera lens, it will give you a warning in the viewfinder. HDR plus control, yes, turn this option on so that you can choose whether you want to take a HDR plus photograph or you want to take a HDR plus enhanced photograph based on your circumstances at that point of time. Use HDR plus enhanced in portrait mode. This again is, you know, very personal preference. I personally do not use HDR plus enhanced in portrait mode, but if you want to use HDR plus enhanced in portrait mode, you can enable this option. The portrait zoom is needed to be set as Pixel 2 and 3 default, which is 1.2x. Next up is whether you want the sliders for exposure and focus in your viewfinder or not. I am not a pro photographer, so I prefer to keep this option as off. However, if you are a pro photographer and want more control over your exposure and focus, then you need to enable this option and also enable RAW plus JPEG at the same time. So if you enable this option, make sure you enable this option as well, because that is how it works, and it's also mentioned in the comment over here by Sanity. Next up is RAW plus JPEG control. Again, if you want to have RAW photographs, you have to enable this option. Personal preference, I prefer to keep it off. Then next you have store videos efficiently. I personally do not enable this option ever, because you know, my phone is 64 GB. I can always have a 128 GB micro SD card on the Poco F1 and not worry about efficiency when recording videos. Then you have AI, automatic white balance in HDR plus enhanced. This option needs to be toggled to on because it is enabled by default on the Google Pixel 3, and we want to take pictures on a Poco F1 using the Gcam port, which are as close as possible to the Google Pixel 3. JPEG compression, again, disabled, no compression in the photographs. Anti-banding mode, I personally set it as 50 Hertz. Then whether you want to use DCI P3 color space or not, keep it as off. Force on Super Res Zoom, enable this option. As for custom library, make sure you're connected to the internet and then click on Get Updates, and it will download the libraries, and we recommend that you use Stock by Google and then click on OK. The camera application will restart, and if we go back into More, Settings and Advanced, you will see that our custom lib is now set to Stock by Google. So these are all the settings which you can use on your Google camera port by Sanity on the Poco F1. And as I mentioned before, photography is a personal choice, and what might seem a good photograph to me might not seem a good photograph to you. So if you have better settings or some settings which you tweaked, do let me know via comments below. That will do it for this video, peeps. I hope my video helped you. Likes, shares and subscribes are appreciated. Feedback and comment more than welcome. See you when I see you.